Good morning, ma'am. Good morning to all of you. I am Kailat Khan, student of JNM third year. Today, I am going to demonstrate the procedure of neonatal assessment. First of all, definition. Neonatal assessment is the assessment of the newborn from birth to 28 days to know the any congenital abnormalities of the baby and to assess the general condition of the baby. Purpose. To know the congenital abnormalities of the baby, to assess the general condition of the baby, and to ensure the physical well-being of the baby. Before starting the procedure, following principles should be kept in mind: preparation of nurse, preparation of articles, preparation of client and unit, step of procedure, termination of articles, recording report, and health education. Preparation of nurse, physical and mental. Physical, hair should be tidy, dress should be neat and clean, sleeve should be above the elbow, nails should be cut short, shoes should be well covered. Mentally, thorough knowledge regarding the procedure, less harm and more benefit to the patient. Now the preparation of articles. A tray containing following articles. Drap sheet to cover the baby, gloves to prevent from cross infection, paper bag for dirty purpose. Cotton swabs to clean the discharge. Gauze piece to clean the site. Stethoscope to know any whizzing sound. Newspaper to spread and check the length of the baby. Inch tape to check the length of the baby. And thermometer to check the temperature of the baby. Pen and diary to note down the reading. And watch to note down the rates of the baby. And
including this, we need the one temperature tray to monitor the vital sign of the newborn. So that tray is not, we are not kept here. But that is necessary when we are doing the newborn assessment. So the next step is.
And weighing machine to note, to take the weight of the baby. Now the preparation of the patient. First of all, we take the consent of the consent from the mother for the assessment of her baby, and properly explain all the procedure to the baby which you are going to done on the baby. Now the नमस्ते बिमला जी, आज मैं आपके बच्चे को चेक करने वाली हूँ. आपके बच्चे में कोई बीमारी तो नहीं है? कोई अभी तक मैं आपके बच्चे को आज चेक करूंगी और इसका बुखार भी देखूंगी. सारी चीजें इसमें चेक करूंगी. मैं कर सकती हूँ क्या?
टेक ऑफ द बेबी फ्रॉम द मदर टू द अदर साइड. सो वी विल स्टार्ट द असेसमेंट ऑफ द न्यूबॉर्न. सो वी विल स्प्रेड फर्स्ट one sheet to baby according to our convenience. Firstly, we will see the general condition of the baby. After that, we will measure the head circumference. So we will open the baby very less, because we will expose only the needed area. So that will help in prevention of the hypothermia. So firstly, we will measure the head circumference. It is 34, and in head, after that we will see the shape of the head. After that we will put one hand from the back occiput to the frontal. In that we will see the fontanelle of the babies. This is the posterior fontanelle, or this one the anterior, and we will see the sagittal suture. If there is a excessive molding at that time, this bone will overlap to the other bone, so that will also assess during the physical examination of the newborn. After that we will see the shape of the baby. If head is so big, it indicates there is a hydrocephalus. If head is less than 30 centimeter, it is less than 29 centimeter, and that indicates it is microcephalus. And in case of, if there is a frog-like shape of the head, that indicates there will be, the head is
anencephalus.
So after that, we will see the cephalohematoma. and tapping septum. That is the abnormality which occur during the birth of the baby. So after that we will put the baby in lie down position. Then we will see the ear of the baby. We will make the one line from the tip of the ear to the outer canthal of the eyes. We will see the symmetry of the ears. If it is above the outer canthal of the eyes, it indicates there will be a mental retardation. If it is below the outer canthal of the eyes, it indicate Down syndrome. After that we will see the globular reflex. We will put the thumb here and pinch the over the globular and pinch, put the pressure over that. At that time baby will open their eyes. After that we will see the reflexes of the eyes. We will put the torch over the eyes and see the reflexes of the eyes. So at that time the eyes will be blink, and the eye in case of the newborn the eye is very clear and bright. After that we will come down and we will see the rooting reflex of the baby. If we will put the we will stimulate here, at that time the baby will turn their neck toward the stimulation side. After that we will come down and we will see the sucking reflex, and we will check the cleft palate, which we can not visualize. If it is present, then we will put the one finger into the mouth of the babies and see the palate. That will helpful to know the cleft status of the palate. And with this, the baby will suck our finger. That will help to know the sucking reflex of the baby. After that, we will put some cotton bowl into the nostril of the baby. That will helpful to know the sneezing reflex of the baby. When we will put some cotton here, baby will sneeze out. After that, we will come down and we will see the neck of the baby. That can be the tonic neck. If we will a range of motion is not adequate of the baby. Baby's neck is not able to move normally. Not a adequate range of motion. That show there will be a tonic neck reflex. After that, bull neck. We can say it bull neck. If the neck is very big, large, it will show the bull neck. After that, we will come down. We will cover the head of the baby because we want to prevent the baby from heat loss, so prevent from the hypothermia. After that we will come down. We will see the chest circumference of the baby. We will measure from the it over the nipple line, how much it was? 8. It is normal, it is less than 2 cm of the head, so it can be 30 after birth. So after that we will see the abdominal circumference. It will be 29. So this is the abdominal circumference and chest circumference, or even we can check the mid-arm circumference. With the help of that is the one instrument that is not as the clip board, that will put over the mid point of the arm and see the thickness of the subcutaneous tissue. So that we will also check. After that we will see the fetal heart sound of the baby. We will put the stetho over the chest. So we will listen the fetal heart sound of the baby. It will be 140 to 160 after birth. After that we will see the lung sound of the baby. So we will put the stethoscope side, little both side of the, but we cannot put here, but it we will put the sidelines. Here we will see the sound of the lungs with the help of stethoscope, normal lung, and also see the respiration rate of the baby. After that, we will see the shape of the chest. In that, there will be a if it is normal shape, but if it can be two type. One is the pigeon shape, one is the barrel shape. That is not a normal chest. After that, we will see the capillary refilling. Yes. We will put the finger over the abdomen and will put it provide the pressure over here up to the 15 seconds and leave it. Our capillary refilling time is less than 2 seconds. After that, we will listen the bubble sound of the newborn. So the it will listen after 13 minutes. We will put the stetho and listen the bubble sound. So we will listen the bubble sound. It will be 30 to 40 per minute. So we can listen. After that, we will see the status of the umbilicus. So we will see there should be no redness, there should be no discharge around the umbilicus, and see the status of the umbilical cord. If it is, we are doing the physical examination of the baby after immediate after the birth. It is pinkish in color, and there will be a brightness because Bartholin jelly is present there. So it become brightness. But if we will do the physical assessment of this newborn after 24 hours, so it become little bit brown or it become little bit dry. It is not in a wet. So we will see that there should be no infection. After that, we will cover the baby. Then we will see the check the upper extremity. So firstly, we will check the finger of the newborn to know the any peripheral cyanosis and also know the polydectomy. And similarly, we will check this in second hand also. After that, we will check the grasping. We will put the finger into the hand of the baby, and after that, baby will hold it, grasp it. That is known as the grasping reflex. Normal baby remain like that, in flex position. Or if it is like that, it is relaxing. It is not active. Active baby remain like that. Okay. Then we will put this over the hand of the newborn, and we can see the lower extremity. So in lower extremity, firstly we will see the symmetry of the legs. So leg can be small or it can be short leg or long leg. So we will extend the leg and see the shape of the legs. Upper extremity we can cover with the help of. After that, we will see the fingers of the lower limbs. So there will be a polydectomy and syndectomy. And here we will see the bewitching reflex. We will do like that. The baby will flex their finger like that. So, and also see the polydectomy and syndectomy. After that, we will do the range of the motion of the baby. So we can move the legs of the baby like that. It will show adequate range of motion. If baby is female, then we will see the genital organs of the baby. But my baby is male. In that, I will see if there is a opening over the penis. It show hyperpidiasis. If the opening below the penis, it show epipidiasis. There is a congenital abnormality. After that, we will see the scrotum. So we will put the two fingers here and will touch the descending of the scrotum with the help of finger. That show our baby is full term. If our baby is female, in that we will see the labia minora and labia majora will cover the clitoris. That indicate our baby is full term. If it is not covered, it show that our baby is preterm, and under there will be pseudo menstruation. So that is the normal things. It can be there, and also see the swelling of the labia minora and labia minora. After that, we will see, we will take the history of the mother. Is the baby should pass the urine and stool within urine should be passed within 24 hours and stool must be passed into 48 hours. If stool is not passed, then we will put the little finger into the anus of the newborn. We will check at the is the anus is perforated or unperforated. So it is, if it is unperforated, at that time we will send the baby for surgery because it is a emergency. So even we will see the creases here. If here this no creases, it show the, our baby is mature. If more creases is there, it show our baby is premature. And other we think there is we see the condition of the skin. Newborn baby, healthy baby remain pink in color, or there should be no other rashes. Little bit birthmarks will be there, but there is no abnormality in the skin of the babies. After that, we will see the back of the babies. With the help of, firstly, we will hold the baby like that, and we will put the baby like that and hold the cloth of the baby up to the scapular lesion, and we will see the abnormality of the spinal cord. Because there will be a neural tube defect, there will be a spinal bifida, meningocele and meningomyelitis. That will be present after the birth. When there is a congenital abnormalities, then we will see the Mongolian spot. It will be over the sacral region. So that is the normal thing. And we will see the cleft fit. The fit will be inward. So that is also the birth abnormality. This is about the newborn assessment. After that, we will see the, we will check the motor reflex also. We will hold the both hand of the babies and we will put like that. The baby will cry and baby will fear when we are putting the baby back to their bed. Then we will put the baby over the newspaper to measure the length of the baby. So we will put like that. So we will put one mark here. And we will hold the legs like that. And measure with the help of inch tape. After that, we will take the weight of the baby. So first we will take the, if we have the, this type of the weighing machine, at that time we will tell the mother to take their own weight. After that, they will hold the baby. Rest of the baby will be with the mother. So one student will go over the machine, weighing machine. Is that it? 50 kg. So hold this baby. It is 2.5. Weight is 2. After that, we will cover the baby. Like that, and give it to the mother, and give to the mother. हमने आपके बच्चे को आपके पास रख लिया है. आपका बच्चा बिल्कुल स्वस्थ है. So thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.